Thank you very much. It's a great honor for me to have the occasion to speak here. And I must apologize for mainly reading my speech because of time problems and language problems. Well, here you see the content of my speech. Thank you. Yeah. My topic are the human rights standards in Europe and the ban against the headscarf, the burqa, and the niqab. While Belgium began with an initiative to ban full body covering of Muslim women in public, better known under the names burqa and niqab, more and more politicians from European countries competed in demanding such a burqa ban as well. Meanwhile, France has outstripped Belgium and will probably implement the new prohibition in a few months. Then it will be prohibited to appear with a full body covering, including a face cover, in public sites, in restaurants, public transport, even walking in the streets, and visiting a market will be a criminal offense. As it seems to be attractive for political audiences in several countries, we could read in the newspapers about such plans or demands from Switzerland, Spain, Austria. Even in the United Kingdom, politicians try to draw attention on such radical and unusual demands. Some governments gave signs of refusal, said that's not necessary. Others, especially the Swedish and the Norwegian, opposed such a burqa ban. But it seems as if there is no bigger challenge for Europe than the threat by fully covered Muslim women. Here I show you pictures of the headscarf, the burqa, niqab and burqa, niqab. Yeah. Does all this make sense? What are we talking about? How many women are affected? Maybe in France between some 100 and 2,000, in other countries only one or two dozens. Most of them live probably in Britain, but there the ban seems to have very little chance to succeed in Parliament. The main question is why? Why is there a need to discipline these few people? Do they any harm to others? Why shouldn't they be allowed to walk in the streets, to use public transport? Is it only for reasons of safety because of the global war on terror? But there is a simple objection. So many other persons could hide bombs under their coats by showing their face. What can be other reasons for the new approach of restriction that must be understood as a further demarcation against Muslims who adhere to religious and other old-fashioned traditions? Is tolerance towards cultural diversity and integration of Muslim citizens now out of sight? Definitely. And how did this come? For me, the most interesting question is, are these legal measures compatible with human and constitutional rights, with the Western and especially European principles and values? I will try to answer these questions, although it is hard to understand, and sufficient explanations would require more time and thorough glance on all complex connections and interrelations.